Hi, everyone. I'm Janet Miranda in News and Entertainment. Really excited to be here today at the historic Belmore Movies and Show Place located in Nassau County of Long Island in Belmore, New York. We're here for the 22nd annual Long Island International Film Expo, where over 150 films ranging from features to shorts to documentaries and animation are being screened for audiences and celebrities worldwide. We're going to show you guys some exclusive interviews from the winners of this amazing film expo. So please stay tuned to see more in News and Entertainment. Oh, and by the way, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, what are you waiting for? We're bringing you the best in news entertainment. So go ahead, click, like, and subscribe. I'm Janet Miranda, your host at News and Entertainment. I'm Janet Miranda, your host at News and Entertainment. I'm here with this incredibly stunning woman.
Oh. Hi.
Abigail Hawk.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about you, but first, what's your name?
I'm Robert Clohessy with the Long Island Film Festival, and I'm presenting and giving out an award tonight.
What kind of awards are you giving out?
I'm giving out the Creative Achievement Award to my lady right here, Abigail Hawk.
Wait, that's me. I'm getting an award?
You are. And did you know I was giving the award to you?
No.
What?
I'm really excited, guys. I'm really excited.
You guys are going to have to stay tuned to see this whole experience. But before we go any further, you're getting a creative award.
I am.
What is it called, creative?
It's called the Life Creative Achievement Award.
I mean, that's incredible by itself.
Thank you.
You know, Abigail, for those folks that are unfamiliar with the film festival and the film world overall and television world overall, can you just tell us a little bit about like your background with respect to how you got to where you are today?
Well, how much time do we have, ladies and gentlemen? Well, we'll cut to the chase. I moved to New York right after graduating from the University of Maryland. I got a degree in theater, so I've been doing this my entire life. Struggled for a long time doing the underground theater scene, and in 2010, landed a walk-on role on Blue Bloods, which was a brand new show. And a couple episodes later, they just kept bringing me back. I guess I did something right. And, you know, Tom Selleck and I are best friends now. Contrary to what this guy will tell you, he is not Tom's best friend.
Officer Davis is out of surgeries and recovering.
Brian took a bullet to his neck, which severed his jugular. Did I ever show you Brian's department photo? You're not supposed to, but he smiled on purpose. He said every time you see a cop shot on the front page of the paper, it's always the official photo and they look so serious. He figured if he smiled, it was some sort of guarantee that nothing bad would happen to him.
You might be right.
I've promised him all kinds of things if he gets better.
So I hear you're one of the actors on Blue Bloods as well?
Yes, I am.
A lieutenant,
Sid Gormley. I'm kind of Tom Selleck sidekick with Abigail and Gregory.
Yes.
We're kind of a threesome there.
Yes, Greg's not here though, so we're flying duo.
We're a duet tonight.
We're duetting.
Duet is kind of great. I'll be your trio for the rest of the evening. But
Sweet. Just
to get back to, you play a detective.
I do, yes.
So how is that, just getting into character and being a cop?
It's hot.
What is that?
It's hot.
It's hot.
It's hot.
Over here.
Yeah.
I know there's
it's an amazing opportunity, I think, to humanize our men and women that are in law enforcement and to really just put a face behind the badges and the shields and create actual human beings. Mm-hmm. But really, it's just, you know, another job. We're held to a higher standard as detectives and police officers, and I think it's really important to show the honesty and the humanity behind that. Mm-hmm. So,
and did you have to kill anybody on the show?
Ooh, not yet, but I do get to do that in my new movie.
Yeah,
oh, tell us a bit about your movie.
I just finished wrapping work on The Wrong Path, which is an independent feature. It's a modern-day film noir, and I am nothing like my character on Blue Bloods. I'm a bad girl.
You're a bad girl.
Very bad.
And what's wrong with a bad girl?
Nothing
at all. So tell us, what do you do that you are being a bad girl, not you again?
Oh.
We'll get to you in a minute.
He's always a bad girl. Well, she's a modern-day femme fatale, and she's all about, you know, the next scheme and the quick buck and making money. She just wants to go to Mexico, which isn't that believable because somebody as pale as me really has no business in being in Mexico because I fry in
sunscreen.
The sun. Yes, SPF 500
That's
is
it.
How I survived that.
I could totally see you as like a femme fatale, by the way, like a James Bond girl kind
it
of thing.
It was very fun. It made the overnight shoots much easier to handle because at the end of the day, if I was a little crazy, worked for the character, so.
Now, how tough is it juggling a family and having a career as an actress, a successful actress, that's doing all the things that you're doing?
Well, the only reason I'm honestly really able to do it is because my husband is currently on leave from his job. He's a lieutenant paramedic with FDNY.
Amazing.
And he is on 4 years of childcare leave. So he is our stay-at-home parent right now while I am working, and that allows me to, you know, work weird hours but still be present as a mom. So.
But what an incredible partnership for you to have with your husband who supports you and your craft and all the things that you want to do. I mean, you're a very lucky woman to have someone in your corner that way.
I am. Very, very lucky.
And how long are you guys married?
We've been married 10 years.
10 whole years? Yes. That's like a decade.
It is actually a decade. And how long have you been married, Bob?
33.
33 years, that's a lot longer than anything I can think of.
3 decades plus 3.
So it's Bob, weird.
Tell us, how long have you been acting?
I was a fighter. I grew up in a fighting family, and then I got hurt. And I went to a community college, I walked into an acting class, and that was it.
Fighter like MMA or boxing or what?
Boxing.
Oh, okay. Did you fight any?
Golden Gloves, Junior Olympics.
Oh, wow.
I had like 40 amateur fights.
Wow. What do you
like
better?
I always pick one with her, too. Yeah.
He's a professional fight picker.
Uh-oh. What do you like better, acting or fighting?
Acting.
Yeah, because you can kind of pretend, you know, you can actually act that you're being a boxer.
Yeah, it's nicer to get my soul hurt than my face hurt.
Uh-oh. What was your favorite role that you've ever done?
Probably on... oh, God, I forget the film.
That's because he's been hit in the head so many times as a boxer. He forgets his lines, too, guys.
I just think it's because you're standing next to him in this stunning dress and looking fabulous. Am I right?
Yes.
Absolutely.
I'm a little frazzled.
Even it has nothing to do with the wine.
I've been seeing it for 10 years.
Not 5 minutes after the lights go out, my cell goes off. Restricted caller, it says.
I never picked those up.
Well, neither do I. But it's a blackout. What am I supposed to do? It's the mayor.
Right.
Exactly. And she's got like this shopping list of blocks where she wants extra manpower.
And it's the mayor, you can't exactly...
Exactly. So I say, thank you, Madam Mayor. I'll get right on it. I mean, what else could I do?
She says, jump, you say how high.
And if I say no, this has to go through the PC. What am I doing?
Throwing a PC into the wood chipper.
Exactly.
Except that the blocks around the Vladek houses?
Yes.
That's the problem.
It's all a problem, Sid. But what am I going to do? Tell the mayor that there's these dollar stores and bodegas that take precedent over her donors and her cronies? I mean, we all serve at the pleasure of the mayor, am I right?
Pretty much.
Plus, I'm saving the boss this headache.
You did the right thing, Benny. Under the circumstances.
So you guys know each other for 10 years?
Yeah.
Wow.
So yeah, we're best buds.
Meet?
On the show.
The show.
Blue Bloods.
Yep, on the show.
Wow.
Yep.
Okay, so you went on there as just a day player.
Yes.
And you got cast to be a...
Come back,
yep. Which is great. And you met Bob over here.
I did, yeah.
We became really good friends. Have you done other films together, other projects?
No.
No.
Which is weird, but we will, because we know all the same people.
We do sing a lot.
We sing a whole
lot.
On
Instagram.
On Instagram and Facebook.
Yeah. We're big hits.
Can you give us a little treat and give us just a little tiny treat?
Why do birds suddenly appear every time Abigail's here? Just like me, we all long to be close to Hawk.
Aww.
Abigail!
See what happens, Janet. You give him a mic, he takes a mile.
I love it. Guys, where can the world find you guys? Online, where can they find your information?
I'm at Hawk Abigail on Instagram, and I'm on Facebook at Abigail Hawk. And I'm on Twitter sometimes at Abigail_Hawk.
I'm at 42nd and 9th at the coffee shop. You want to drop by, have some coffee?
He's on there too. You'll find him, but his account is constantly hacked because he doesn't know how to use the internet. So.
Not yet, but guys.
I'm a 70s child. I can't figure it out. I don't know.
We're bringing you entertainment here at News Entertainment, but we're not done just yet because I just want to know, what about theater? I know that you said that you've done some theater and you sound like you should be on Broadway.
Oh yeah, baby. I was in 12 Angry Men for a year. You see that show? Fantastic.
Obviously, it was typecast.
And I was in Pal Joey, the musical, on Broadway.
It's a true story.
And I was in Rounding Third on Broadway.
Guys, these are real theatrical trained professionals who are over here giving you guys a little bit of their, you know, talent, a song. He is over here today giving out awards. Is this the first time you're giving out awards?
Yeah, mostly I've gotten them. Whoa!
But now it's time for fresh young blood to get awards.
She's letting you know it's not always about you.
So, you know, sometimes the ship sails and sometimes it sinks.
And I'm ready to sail.
Well, hopefully we'll be sailing along together at newsandentertainment.com. So guys, stay tuned.
We fed it to her.
I'm Janet Miranda. This is Abigail.
And Robert Clohessy.
Thanks for watching.
Stay tuned, guys.
Yeah, baby.
It's a didgeridoo, an Australian wind instrument, a little bit like a trumpet.
Oh. Thank you.
It's a gift from the Prime Minister of Australia for hosting him last week.
A donation to the NYPD Museum? Brian's doing better.
He is. Thank you.
Thought you weren't coming in for a few weeks.
I told Jimmy I'd relieve him for a few hours. I could use the break.
Things are bad if work's a break.
Actually, things are very good. Brian is breathing on his own. He's complaining about hospital food. And they're gonna release him tomorrow.
Good news.
Maybe you should rethink that no smile policy. I have accompanied you on many, many hospital visits to officers who have been injured in the line of duty, some who have died in the line of duty. I knew it was your job. What I never fully understood was just how important your visit is to the officer's family. And now I know. Thank you.
Want to see more videos? Subscribe to our YouTube News and Entertainment channel. Click right below.
Please be sure to check us out at News and Entertainment on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, on YouTube, and you can check us out at newsandentertainment.com for all the breaking news in entertainment.